Hi, I'm Annette Böckler. In the first film, you learned some things in general about Tamehamikra. In this film, you will get to know the tunes of the signs. The first sign to know is called Mercha, or Ma'arich in the Sephardi tradition.
Mercha.
The name means lengthener.
Mercha. Mercha. Mercha.
The next sign is called Tipcha, or Tarcha at Sephardim.
Tipcha.
This means hand breath.
Tipcha.
It's a grade 3 disjunctive. Then there is Munach. This means resting or sustainer.
Munach.
It's a very common connector, so weak that its melody constantly adapts to what
Munach.
Follows.
Munach.
Etnachta means resting point. Atnach at Sephardim.
Etnachta.
It's the major division of the phrase, like a semicolon.
Etnachta. Etnachta.
The whole phrase is this.
Mercha. Tipcha. Munach. Etnachta.
In properly printed style, it looks like this.
Mercha.
It is not necessary that all four signs occur in a phrase. When one of them is missing, I would recommend to think the tune in silence and continue loud with what is written. The pause feels only long to you yourself. Let's try. Try to chant the line first, then I will chant it and you can check if you were right. Let's start with the full clause.
Mercha, tipcha, munach, etnachta. Tipcha, munach, etnachta. Mercha, tipcha, etnachta. Tipcha, etnachta. Mercha, tipcha.
Now let's add a new sign. Sof Pasuk, end of the verse.
Sof Pasuk. Sof Pasuk. Sof pasuk. Thank you.
The sof pasuk clause is this.
Melcha tibra, melcha sof pasuk.
Try to chant these sentences.
Melcha tibra, melcha sof pasuk. Tibra, melcha sof pasuk. Melcha tibra sof pasuk. Tibra sof pasuk. Melcha tibra, melcha sof pasuk. Melcha tibra, munach et nachta. Melcha tibra, melcha sof pasuk.
Maybe you would like to pause this video for a while and try to memorize these two phrases first before you learn more phrases. A very common clause is the sakef katon clause. You may know it from Le Ma'an Tiskeruhu Munach Sakef Katon.
Katma Mabach Pashta Munach Katon. Katma Mabach Pashta. Katma mabach pashta munach katon. Katma mabach pashta. Mabach pashta munach katon. Pashta munach katon. Pashta katon. Pashta katon. Cut
there may be a munach at the beginning.
Munach, mapach, pashta, munach, katon.
There can be a yetif in this clause, always only in the second part of the clause.
Yetif, munach, katon.
Makel zakef. It looks like a pashta and a zakef katon in one word. But the tune for this is special.
Makel zakef.
Don't worry if you can't do this one at the moment. You will survive without it.
Makel zakef.
These are the phrases that you now already know.
Mercha tibra munach et nachta. Mercha tibra, mercha sof pasuk. Kadma mapach pashta. Mercha tibra munach et nachta. Mercha tibra, mercha sof pasuk. Kadma mapach pashta munach katon.
This is the Revia clause. Revia means four. The sign has a tune with four notes.
Munach, munach, revia. Munach, revia. Revia.
Now you know the four most common clauses. If you want to chant Torah, you chant the word in the Torah instead of the name of the sign. So the first verse in the Torah has Tibcha munach et nachta, Mercha tibcha mecha sof pasuk.
Tibcha munach et nachta, Mercha tibcha mecha sof pasuk. Bereshit bara Elohim et hashamayim ve'et haaretz. Bereshit bara Elohim Et ha-shamayim ve-et ha-aretz. Ve-aretz ha-yita tohu v'avohu, v'choshech al p'nei tehom, v'ruach Elohim merachefet al p'nei ha-mayim. Vayomer Elohim yehi ohor, vayehi ohor.
Vayara Elohim
et ha-ohor ki tov. Vayavdehel Elohim bein ha-ohor uvein ha-choshech. Vayikra Elohim la-ohor yom ve-la-choshech kara laila. Vayehi erev, vayehi boker, yom echad.